Good morning, friends. Let us start today's session. In this, we will be discussing about paints, varnish, and distemper. So, paint is a solution or a suspension of pigments, binder, and minor mineral solvents that on drying forms an adherent film on the surface it is applied for, either for protection or for decoration. Constituents: a base, inert filler, coloring pigment, vehicle, solvent, even you will use regularly as thinner and dryer. These are the constituents required to manufacture paint. Characteristics: it should stick well to the surface, able to seal the porous substrata. Consistency should provide easy workability. Thickness of the paint film should be adequate for good protection. Should dry rapidly. Dried paint film should be able to withstand the weather effects for a long time. Offer resistance to failure like cracking, flaking. Possess good moisture resistance. Should not fade off. Basic expectations. So base, pigments commonly used as the principal constituents. What are the various types of paints available? White lead, red lead, zinc white, iron oxide, titanium white, lithophon. These are the bases in generally available. Vehicles used: oil type, linseed oil, raw linseed, boil linseed, double boil linseed oil, poppy oil, nut oil. These are the vehicles. What we have seen earlier is base used. Along with that base, this vehicle will be added. Then coloring pigments. This is used to give desired color. It can be a black pigment, brown pigment, blue pigment, yellow pigment, red pigment, and green pigment. Depends on that pigment, the color can be developed. From black, lamp black, vegetable black, graphite black, similarly from other colors. Types of paints. So, paints constituents are base, filler, vehicle, thinner, additive, and coloring pigments. So we have seen the different types of base, vehicle, coloring pigment. Filler, thinner, additive are all common in general. So because of this ingredients, various types of paints can be manufactured. The types can be aluminum paints, anti-corrosive paints, asbestos paints, bituminous, bronze, cellulose, casein, cement based, enamel paints, oil paints, and rubber based paints. These are some of the types of paints. So this is aluminium paint, anti-corrosive paints, asbestos paints, cement based, oil. So process of painting on different surfaces. In generally, the process of painting on woodwork can be divided into the following stages. First, we need to prepare the surface, knotting, priming coat, stopping, surface coat, and finally finishing coat. Painting can be done with the brush, right? So prior to painting, the loose bristles should be, how to make that brush ready? The loose bristles should be removed by tapping the brush gently against the palm of the hand. So twirling it rapidly between the palms of the hand, put the loose bristles out. So brush should not be dipped too deeply into the paint. Excess paint should be removed by gently rubbing the brush against the side surface of the paint pot. This is how the brush to be initially made loose and dipped into the paint. Spray painting. If it is a spray painting, it's a developed technique, efficient method. There is also economy in labor and the consumption of material, as well as only 2 coats of spray are considered sufficient to obtain the desired finish. Varnish. So varnish is a clear, pale solution. It's dissolved in either oil, turpentine or alcohol. Varnish plays an important role in finishing wooden surfaces of doors, windows, furnitures, floors, etc. Types of varnish: oil, spar, flat, asphalt, spirit. These are the different types of varnishes. Spar, flat, asphalt, spirit. How the varnish can be used. Proportion. First one is actually, the slide is little, I don't know how. Okay, we'll manage. So materials required to manufacture that varnish. The first one is linseed oil of 16 liter. Then methylated spirit 2 liter. Vinegar 1 liter, turpentine 1 liter, copal varnish 1 liter and hydrochloric acid 0.75 liters. This is the ingredients required to manufacture varnish. So all these are readily available in market, can be purchased and mixed together to form the varnish. That's about varnish. Next is distempers. Distemper paint is an ancient type of paint that can be traced back to the earliest eras. It's an early form of whitewash made of water, chalk and pigment. It is often bound with animal based glue, like adhesive qualities of casein resin that comes from solidified milk. Yeah. Primary problem with the distemper paint is that it is not durable. For this reason, it is used more often for temporary or inexpensive projects rather than fine art. The new plaster is allowed to dry for at least 2 months before applying distemper. In case of old surfaces, all dust, dirt, scales and greasy marks should be removed and all the holes and cracks should be filled with plaster of Paris mixed with dry distemper of the color to be used. A coat of whiting is then applied over the prepared dry clean surface, which acts as the priming coat for the distemper. The dry distemper is then converted into a liquid by mixing it with water and stirring it well. As a rule, 0.6 liter of water should be used per kg of distemper. This is the preparation of surface for applying distemper. So surface to be prepared, then apply wall putty, sand the putty, apply the primer coat, finally our distemper coat. This is the steps to apply the distemper paint. So its types can be many. Oil bound distemper contains some drying oils to enhance its spreading and drying characteristics. Drying oil is rendered mixable with water. In general, oil cannot mix with water. This is rendered into a mixable with water. The distemper is in pasty form. It's available in different shades and sealed tins. Casein paints is a protein substance derived from milk curds. It's made by working in a mixture of finely ground casein with a base of white pigments, maybe slaked lime, and the solid in powdered or paste form in sealed tins. On account of their high opacity, give pleasing results in one coat. They are applied on new plaster without any danger of blistering, scaling or any adverse effects of free alkali. That's about the session. Thank you for listening, guys.